romantic comedies always come with great expectations. They better be funny and they better touch your heart. And more than that, you have filmmaking at its finest. The Big Sick is all that and an awkward true story, like it says in the poster. And I'm going to continue gushing as I welcome to the Exchange Television Studio the star and the writer, Kumail Nanjiani. Kumail, so nice to have you here.
Oh, thanks for having me.
I do want to gush about this movie. It is absolutely wonderful. It's a love story. It's a comedy. I cried. I laughed.
Oh, good.
How much more? I mean, you put everything in
there.
Yeah,
what more do you want? Yeah, you laugh, you cry. That's great. Thank you so much. That means a lot to me.
But even more interesting is this is a true story, and it's the story of you and your wife.
Yeah, it's sort of based on about the first year of our relationship when we met and sort of slowly fell in love. And you know, we've been married now 10 years.
Okay.
So
it's working.
It's working.
Watch and learn, bye. Oh, crust.
I have to tell you something, bye. I've been dating this girl. She's white.
A white girl?
Okay, you can't look like you and yell white girl.
It's okay. We hate terrorists.
I wonder who that could be.
I'm guessing it's a young, single Pakistani woman.
This is Zubeda.
For your files? Your ex-files? That's your favorite show, huh?
The truth is out there.
Are you judging Pakistan's next top model?
You know how we have arranged marriage in my culture?
Oh my God, I'm so stupid.
Can you imagine a world in which we end up together?
I don't know.
What made you think that your love story would be a movie?
Well, because we knew it was a very specific story. We knew that nobody else had this story because a lot of crazy stuff happened to us our first year. And you know, this happened about 10 years ago. And so 5 years from the events of the movie, I started thinking, I was like, you know, I would like to see this story as a movie, and only we have this story. So the only way I can see this movie is if we make it. Like, if we don't tell this story, the story doesn't get told. So that's kind of what the impetus was. And we knew, like, that if we did a good job, it would sort of be about all the things that my wife and I think about that are important to us, you know.
There's an infection. We put her in a medically induced coma.
Coma.
You should call her family.
Thank you, Kumail. We're gonna handle things from here.
I think I'm just gonna wait anyway.
You guys broke up. I'm not sure why you're here.
I'm just gonna stay for a second. Is this seat? Okay. Is that lady still looking at me?
So, 9/11. I've always wanted to have a conversation with people.
You've never talked to people about 9/11?
I mean, when we do a biopic about people, when we see biopics, most of the movies are about someone who is dead and died probably tragically.
And famous.
And famous, yes.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's what I'm... So this was a little... It's kind of a stretch, I would think. In some ways, people might go, what? Really? Who
yeah.
is this guy? And this who is this girl?
This isn't Lincoln.
Yeah.
This isn't Ali. This is why it's not called Kumail, you know? It's we really wanted to sort of... use our story as the jumping off point and sort of tell a fictionalized version of it that would work as a story on its own. So, you know, the first draft we wrote of the movie was like fully 100% factual. And then Judd Apatow, who was the producer of the movie, he was like, all right, now divorce yourself from this story. You have all this material. Make a story that would be interesting to other people.
I think I screwed up with your daughter.
Yeah, you did.
Let me give you some advice, Kumail. Love isn't easy. That's why they call it love.
I don't really get that.
I know. I thought I could just start saying something and something small would come out.
Kumail,
yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
are
so
delight.
Much.
I mean, I will yell from the mountaintop, wherever I can, people need to go see this movie. It's absolutely wonderful. It'll be fun when it comes out on Blu-ray. I can watch it over and over and over
yeah.
again. So thank you for everything. In fact, we just want you to make sure, find The Big Sick wherever you are. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for
having
me.